They are, Aaron. The police chief here in Sunapee says it seems like the whole town has either stopped by or is in the process of stopping by. Now, they are still in the process of putting together a plan to haul the boat out. The Department of Environmental Services, along with New Hampshire Marine Patrol, making sure no unexpected surprises, but it'll probably be tomorrow before the necessary equipment is in place to remove the boat.
Very sad to see this.
For people in the Lake Sunapee area, the MV Kearsarge is more than just a cruise boat. It's a part of their community and their lives.
Had our rehearsal dinner on it when we got married, and you know, we ride on it every couple of years, take our kids out, family comes, visitors.
The 66-foot vessel flooded Thursday night. It was reported around 7:30, and at this point, no one is sure what happened.
I had been at the boat 3 hours before, just doing its normal daily check just to make sure everything looked good, and did a visual check of the outside. Everything looked great.
The stern of the boat now sits in about 8 feet of water, a boom in place to contain any fuel leaks. Throughout the morning, people stopped by, a tough sight for many to take in.
Just disbelief. It's I heard about it just a short while ago. I came down and I thought I was imagining things.
Al Peterson is one of the captains of the boat. For 30 years, he's cruised the waters of the lake, and like others, he's puzzled as to why the boat flooded.
Whether it was a valve or a hose or something that just let go at the wrong time.
The owners say while they don't know how badly the boat's been damaged, their plan is to haul the boat out and put it back in service. And everyone who stopped by has expressed the hope that this isn't the end of an era.
That I've been on this lake since 1943. And there have been several boats like this. It has been always fun to watch it go around the lake.
You can see some of the people that have gathered here by the boat. This particular boat has been in service since 1980 and carried thousands of passengers. Before it's allowed to carry passengers again, it'll have to be inspected. That is assuming, of course, that the damage can be repaired. Reporting live in Sunapee, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.